Who just prayed to?
Jesus said in Luke 19, verse 27, bring all the people who don't want me to be...
And kill them in front of me.
Don't me be and kill them king over them.
Don't rule over them and kill them in front of me.
Kill them over me. I love Jesus.
That's the Bible.
Yeah, that's your Bible. The one who don't follow Jesus, what's going to happen to them? What's going to happen to them? Yeah, that's holy war, man.
Have you heard of the word hyperbole?
No. Okay.
That's your homework. You go home and you study the word hyperbole and then read it again. Yeah, all right? You go and read it. You go and read it, bro.
I think he's educated. You hear something repeat and think he's educated.
Bro.
You hear something repeat and think he's educated.
Bro.
He heard the word on TV and he repeated it. I think he's educated.
Bro.
You don't know nothing.
What is it?
If I say to you,
what is it?
If I
you can't answer about the message. You don't know that God just a message. You don't know nothing about the gospel, the origin of the gospel. He knows nothing.
You know nothing. You said
it was full of madmen. Does that mean that every single person here was mad? No, it's hyperbole. It's just to show that it was chaotic. It's another word for chaos. By saying
said the word correctly.
So
mean
Jesus is like saying like that.
You mean hyperbole. You mean hyperbole.
Yeah. Oh,
hyperbole. Said the word correctly.
You mean hyperbole.
Hyperbole. He didn't correct the word. And it doesn't mean hyperbole.
Hyperbole.
That's the correct pronunciation.
Hyperbole. I know.
And messengers and God don't hyperbole.
Yeah. They don't.
You see? I have to.
Hyperbole. You don't know what hyperbole means.
Yeah, hyperbole.
Hyperbole means like a pretense, an exaggeration, a lie. Hyperbole is a lie.
Is a lie.
God doesn't lie and Jesus don't lie.
It's an imagination.
So therefore...
Okay. Can I ask you a question? You've asked me the question.
And you don't know what you're talking
about.
You've
asked me the question.
No, you don't answer it.
Where did they take the people in front of Jesus and slay them? Where did they do it? Show me.
Beside the pine.
He said, bring them to me and kill them. Where did it happen? Show me.
Beside the pine, but you give the order.
He said it in the Bible.
He said it.
Luke 19.
So 1 minute it's hyperbole, and the next minute,
what's hyperbole? I'll tell you again, it's exaggeration, it's a lie.
You said exactly. It was not meant to be true, it was to show.
So you're still lying then?
It was show.
You're still a lie then?
You've taken it, it's not a lie, no.
Hyperbole is a lie.
No.
Hyperbole is exaggerating, it's lie.
Maybe hyperbole.
You know what, really, Joe, we don't
but
have
hyperbole,
to
which is what it is, spoken. Thank you very much. Oh, beautiful, bro. Beautiful.
You know, we're forbidden for doing that.
Sorry?
Prophet would forbid us from exaggerating what people say. We can't allow to exaggerate. It's a lie. It's like pretending it's a lie.
Bro.
Jesus will never do that.
Do you not understand?
Jesus will never do that.
Learn anything.
I have to correct you. You know why you don't learn?
Because you jump all over
no,
the place.
You jump. You're saying one bag of nonsense. Hyperbole. It's not hyperbole. It's hyperbole. I have to correct you. You don't know what it means. You couldn't pronounce it correctly.
Spell it.
H-Y-P-E-R-B-O-L-E.
And you pronounce it hyperbole.
B-O-L-I-N-G. Hyperbowling. It means to exaggerate.
It's hyper. Hyper.
It means to exaggerate.
Listen to what you're saying.
It means to exaggerate. It means to tell a lie. So when you're attributing that to Jesus, look at what you're doing.
Yeah.
And we as Muslims will never attribute a lie to Jesus. That's all low you
are
guys
you
are.
You do it to Muhammad, would you?
No, Prophet would never do that.
The Prophet wouldn't do it.
Digress. When I prove that he's an imposter to Jesus, because you just hear that your ignorance. With your ignorance, you not realize that you. With your ignorance.
I tried to answer the question.
No, you don't.
Wait, one second.
But don't you understand, brother? With respect.
Right here, with your ignorance.
He drains the lifeblood out of you.
And I should drain it out of you because he's a liar.
You never get anywhere with him. He has no spirit.
No, because you don't know what you're saying. You're someone about nonsense. And a while ago, I proved my point. You tend to just lie. You don't realize what you're saying. How can you love man say that he lie? How can you love Jesus say that he lie?
God loves this man. God loves this man so much. He knows and loves the Bible.
Look at this.
These guys are Muslim.
These brothers are Muslim.
He's
a Muslim.
This man is a searcher. And God will come to him in power.
You're an imposter. You don't follow Christ. And you don't love Christ. And when Christ comes back, Christ can say, get away from me, you man of iniquity.
Like in Matthew 7,
Christ can say, get away from me, you man of iniquity, evil people. I never knew you're going to insult your backside. Let me show you how people love Christ. Does Christ lie? Does the Messiah lie?
No.
Does the Messiah lie?
No.
Does the Messiah ever lie?
Sorry?
Does the Messiah ever lie?
He shouldn't.
No. But you just here telling us you love him.
Yeah.
Are you talking about he's hyperboling?
Did I
he's
say lying. Jesus lied?
Yeah, that's
you said
he's
hyperboling.
Hyperboling.
Just to finish this, just to finish it, and I'm going to go.
Hyperboling is lying.
I didn't say Jesus lied. I said that the phrase was hyperbole. I said it was hyperbole. But these people, because they're deceivers,
hyperboling,
because they are demonic, and I've got to say that, they are demonic, and all they do is
hyperboling.
Carry on.
Let me go again.
Demonic. That's why my prayer is that Jesus sets them free.
Hyperboling is going over the top.
Jesus sets them free.
Hyperboling is exaggerating. He's saying what people over the top, going over the top. Jesus is a man of justice. He don't go over the top. He speaks truth like it is.
What is that?
So he does hyperbole.
So
for your,
Jesus,
for your
can you ask this guy, because he won't talk to me.
Nothing.
Can you ask him why Jesus spoke in parables?
It was about himself. Hyperboling is different from a parable. What are you talking? Parables, hyperboling is two separate things.
You are still
understand
here,
what you're saying. When just that parable was about
himself.
No, Jesus was talking about himself. When he see the enemy come, he changed to a king. Because the enemy came, the Pharisees came. But he was talking about himself. And he meant himself. Bring my enemy in front of me. He's talking about himself.
What are the...
Who don't want me to rule over them?
See what he does?
Who don't want me to rule over them and kill them in front of me?
Yeah.
He was talking about himself. It's when the Pharisees come, he put into a parable.
What was it in context? Read the passage.
Because.
Read the passage.
Because the Pharisees.
Read the passage.
The Pharisees did not.
Read the passage.
Yeah. No, you want to get Bible. When we say get Bible, you don't get it out. But you want to get Bible out.
You don't want to
leave. You have to just take Bible out and prove to us, Abraham, and he will never get his Bible out.